How to use high temperature epoxies to fix rotten wood. Now, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to use the high temperature EpoxAmite and high temperature freeform air products to fix rotten wood. And in this project, we're going to hit a couple of goals. We're going to show you how to do it yourself and fix the wood on your project. We're going to show you how to actually fix it without having to replace it and hire this out to somebody, which ends up costing you a lot of money. Of course, we're going to use the correct materials for the environment, in this case, the high temperature products. And we're going to show you how to blend the entire area in so that once it's repaired, it looks done professionally. Now let's just jump into this project and see how it's done. Now, before we start any material mixing or application, we first need to clean the work area. So we're going to start by blowing out and removing any kind of loose debris and dust out of the rotten wood area. The next step is to seal the wood so that no further deterioration can take place. Now, the reason why we're using high temperature epoxies here is because this will be in direct sunlight outside and exposed to the elements. Now, if you live in a warm or hot climate, the material itself can soften due to high temperature and can potentially separate from the repair area. And in order to avoid that, we want to think ahead and use the appropriate material for the application and its surroundings. To seal the old wood, we're going to be using a high-temperature laminating epoxy. This is EpoxAmite HT. This product is designed with high-temperature exposure in mind, but more importantly is to understand the material's working conditions, such as the working time, which is 60 minutes of pot life, and a full cure is achieved after 24 hours. More importantly, this product is mixed by weight only, so we do need to use a gram scale to accurately dispense the A and B. Now, we chose to use the high temperature material for this application because this could be potentially going into a hot or very hot climate, and we want to make sure that the material we choose reflects the needs of its surroundings. I can now go ahead and dispense the part A and the part B because this is a 100A to 33B mix ratio. Accuracy is really important. Now, after we dispense the material accurately, we can go ahead and mix it thoroughly by scraping the sides and scraping the bottom of your mixing container. Now, once the material is mixed thoroughly, we're going to transfer it into a second clean mixing container and mix it one more time by scraping the sides and scraping the bottom. This is called a double mix technique and is a really inexpensive, cheap insurance to prevent any kind of unmixed material ending up on your project. I can now go ahead and apply the EpoxAmite to the wood by simply brushing it over the entire wood surface that we're trying to fix, or seal in this case. By allowing the high temperature epoxy to seep into the dry old wood, we're trying to permanently seal that wood surface so that no further moisture can attack it and prevent it from any further decay. Now, because this will be exposed to high temperature throughout the years, we wanted to make sure to use the right material with the right temperature deflection so that it doesn't fail due to the high temperature exposure anytime soon. A quick look inside the wood cavity allows us to see that the wood is now thoroughly saturated with the epoxy and can now be allowed a full cure for 24 hours. To fill the cavity, we're going to be using the Freeform Air HT, high temperature, lightweight epoxy putty. This material is used for this application specifically because of the high temperature that it withstands. Because this is an outdoor application, we wanted to make sure to use a product that can withstand those type of temperatures, and that's why we're using the Freeform Air High Temp. Now, the working time of this material can be anywhere from 90 minutes to 3 hours, depending on how thick you're applying it. Because it's the high temperature material, this is a 2-to-1 mix ratio, 2A to 1 part of B. And most importantly, the minimum thickness of this material has to be at least half an inch to heat to keep that high temperature resistance. Now I can go ahead and dispense my material. Again, this is a 2-to-1 mix ratio. I can simply go ahead and make two balls off the part A, and then I'm going to change gloves in order not to cause any kind of cross-contamination between the containers or inside the container. And once I have the gloves on, I can go ahead and dispense the part B. And I'm simply going to scoop some out and again make a little ball and match it to the other product that I already have dispensed. This can now get mixed together. Simply knead it together just like you would do bread or dough, and then we're going to fold it over onto itself and continue mixing it until you see no striations. So you can see here there's no striations, a single solid gray color. Now I can go ahead and start applying that to the inside of the cavity. Now, because this is a large cavity and I don't want to fill the entire cavity with the freeform air, we're going to basically line the entire cavity with the freeform air, with a layer of the freeform air, and then cap it and keep it hollow. This prevents me using a lot of material. Also, it prevents the material, the freeform air, which is an exothermic material, from heating up the air particles that are in the material and then expanding. As we know, air expands when it's heated up. Now, here's a little spot on the bottom of the beam. I'm going to fill that as well with the freeform air, and then we're going to proceed to doing some sculpting work and adding texture to it. Now, once we apply the last material, I'm going to spray some water again to smooth out the surface, and then I'm going to use a mixing stick to apply some texture. This is quite easy. The material is easy to maneuver and stamp. And simply here, going to use that mixing stick. I break it and give it a different texture as well with that. And use that mixing stick basically as my tool to add some texture to the final piece in order to match it to the rest of the wood beam. The material is now again allowed a full cure for 24 hours before proceeding on to the next step. Now that the material has fully cured, we can go ahead and finish our project by painting the area with some paint to protect it from the UV light and make the repair look like the rest of the wood surrounding. This is regular outdoor house paint that I picked up from my local hardware store. They color matched it for me so that it would match the rest of the woodwork on the house. And once that is allowed to dry, you can see that the wood repair looks absolutely beautiful and matches the rest of the house. The entire repair ended up taking a little bit over 48 hours in order to let the materials cure thoroughly. This repair is going to last for many, many years and will prevent any further damage to the wood. The material cost of this project is the following. We ended up using half of the trial kit of the EpoxAmite HT, which is $25.12 in material cost for that. And we ended up using a quarter of the gallon kit of the Freeform Air HT, which is $25.76 in material cost. Together brings it to $50.88 on epoxy materials that we ended up using for the repair, making this a much cheaper alternative than actually replacing the entire beam. Now, if you got inspired by this project and you need some material for your own project, you can visit any one of our distributors around the world.
So, and there you have it, a step-by-step procedure that I use to fix the rot on my project here using the high-temperature epoxies. Now, remember, we were able to achieve our goals and do this project ourselves. We're able to save a lot of money by not hiring somebody out and actually fix it, and using the right material for the circumstances by using high temperature products. And of course, we'll show you how to blend the entire area so that it looks professionally done when finished. Now, remember, if you have an idea about what we should do next, please let us know down in the comments below. And if you like this video, hit the thumbs up button. Now, to keep up with our latest mold making, casting, and other videos, remember to subscribe.